So right now, there's only two ways for humans to get into space, but in the next 5-6 years, there's going to be up to 8 more ways to get humans up into space. Hey everybody, welcome to I Need More Space, the show brought to you by a guy whose best scientific credential he has right now is that he spent 1 week in space camp.
I peaked way too soon.
Pretty soon, there's going to be 4 different countries setting up 8 different spacecraft to get humans into space. Which is a pretty big freaking deal. The Russians, as we know, have been using their trusty Soyuz rocket technology. The spacecraft is essentially the same bones as the original design in 1967. It's currently on its 4th generation with 133 flights under its belt. There are currently no plans on shutting the program down, especially since it's the only way we're pretty much getting humans into space at the moment. The Chinese are currently using the Shenzhou spacecraft. It looks a lot like the Russian Soyuz because, well, look at it. It's an exact carbon copy, but yeah, this is a first for China. Yeah, it's not like they've done this before, ever, copying designs. Anyways, 6 of the 11 Chinese missions have been manned. They mostly have been doing some science experiments and trying to crack the whole space station nut, in which they hope to have on their own one day. And India is sending people into space. Well, not yet. Soon, they're hoping soon. They've been on record saying that they could be sending humans into space as early as 2020 or latest 2024, but considering it's 2017 and their last several prototypes have been canceled or modified, I don't really see this happening in that time frame. Not to discount India's space program, they've been having huge success in low Earth orbit. They had a record-breaking launch where they put out 104 satellites off of one booster. That's, like, incredible. All right, on to America's moment. In 2023, they plan on using the Orion spacecraft that will be launched on top of the Space Launch System.
Orion is the only capsule that NASA's developing right now, but it does have the capability of exploring deep space, unlike its predecessor, the shuttle.
Basically, this just means it can go to the moon, Mars, anywhere else in our solar system, technically. It's a pretty dope little capsule. It's basically the newer, better version of the Apollo spacecraft. Okay, so now for private space industry. This is where things are really exciting for me. The private space industry in the States have made massive leaps and bounds in the last decade to get humans into space. Most of these companies are diversifying their business model by targeting not only scientific and exploration missions, but also tourism. Virgin Galactic has been working on their program since 2004. Sadly, they had several setbacks in sending their spacecraft into suborbit. Their owner, Sir Richard Branson, is predicting that they will have their first suborbital flight in 2017. Considering we're about 8 months into the year, I don't really see this happening in 2017, considering they've been pretty quiet on the news front. But I would be even more surprised if it didn't happen by the end of 2018. Virgin Galactic is unique because they are purely targeting space tourism, where 6 passengers can pay $250,000 per ticket for a trip to the other side of the world. The spacecraft will go 110 kilometers at peak altitude, just above the boundary of space. While we're on space tourism, we can also talk about Jeff Bezos and Blue Origin, who's not only targeting space tourism, but they're also targeting commercial flights. They successfully launched and landed their suborbital New Shepard rocket and capsule in 2016, and they are now moving toward the development of their orbital launch vehicle, New Glenn. The New Shepard vehicle, named after Alan Shepard, will primarily be used for space tourism, but they're hoping to send up scientific payloads in conjunction with NASA. New Glenn will be used to send passengers and cargo into orbit, but that vehicle is not planned to begin test flights until the end of 2020. And to bring us home to wrap up the private space industry spacecraft, we're going to go with the two leaders in the NASA's commercial crew program, which are Boeing and SpaceX. Boeing is developing their Starliner space capsule that can seat a crew of up to 7 for a trip to the International Space Station and other orbital destinations. It is only designed for low Earth orbit. It will be adaptable to several different boosters like the Atlas V, Delta IV, Falcon 9. Each capsule is designed to be used up to 10 times before it's retired. Their main client will be NASA, but they have the freedom in their contract to allow one more space tourist per flight to pay for a trip to space. Details on that are still developing. It's really exciting that people are going to have more opportunities for space tourism, and they can just basically piggyback on commercial flights. And last but not least, we have Dragon 2, SpaceX's human-rated space capsule. The 7-passenger capsule, like Orion, is designed to reach destinations as far as Mars, This capsule will likely be the first spacecraft to take astronauts to space from American soil since the space shuttle in 2011, and will mark the beginning of a new era in space exploration. The first crewed launch is planned in early 2018 to the International Space Station, but the real exciting news is that they plan on sending two paying customers to the moon for a quick slingshot and back. I think go to the moon is really exciting. I think, yeah, there's a lot of marketing spin around this, but I think overall it's good for the business and it's good for science in general. It's only going to inspire more young people to get involved into the whole space movement and just make space travel back into the mainstream media, which I think is only going to do good things for all of humankind. Okay, that's my list for now. Now you know that humans are still total badasses sending humans into space, and we have many, many plans in exploring beyond low Earth orbit. So what are you looking forward to most in the next few years for human spaceflight? Please let me know in the comments down below, and please subscribe to my channel. I'm a little baby channel. I have nobody who even knows who I am yet. Anyways, thanks a lot for your time. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll be making many, many more in the future. Thanks.